If you say something bad about them, then it's probably ad hominem. Like if you call Michael Moore a fat slob, it doesn't matter whether he really is or not. And if it's to protect the U.S. reputation, you call it enhanced interrogation. You go to the fallacy of love language, specifically euphemism. And either you buy this car today, or you waste your life away. That's what we call false dilemma, because it ignores a lot of options. Hey, fallacy.
Hey, fallacy.
Hey, fallacy.
Hey, fallacy.
If you think that ghosts exist because there's no proof it's BS, then you're in no shape for believing, cause it's an appeal to ignorance. And if you really, really wanna get high on marijuana because your friends peer pressured you years ago, that's still ad hominem.
Either you buy this car today or live the rest of your life wondering about the luxury of Lexus. That's false dilemma, because you could buy a different car and not wonder at all about what Lexus is like. It is true the U.S. used enhanced interrogation techniques at Guantanamo Bay. That's loaded language euphemism, because it's trying to make torture sound better than it is by using flowery words. There is no global warming at all. Liberals are always looking for something to moan and groan about, and this is their latest wine fest. We're going to call it red herring because it changes the subject. When the person says there's no global warming, you expect them to give evidence that global warming is a hoax. I'm telling you that ghosts exist. Nobody's ever given a definitive proof that there are no ghosts. This is appeal to ignorance, because you're claiming to know something because of the absence of evidence. Smoking a little ditchweed won't hurt you, bro. Just look around. Everybody is doing it. This is ad populum, appeal to popularity. That everyone is doing it does not prove that it is safe without harmful health effects. Oh my gosh, I cannot believe you support immigration reform. Do you know who thought of it? A bunch of idiots in Congress, that's who. The origin of an idea is different from whether that idea is good or bad. So this is ad hominem genetic fallacy, or origin fallacy, we could call it. Instead of addressing whether Michael Moore's latest movie has true claims or not, this attacks his character and him as a person. So this is ad hominem character attack. Back in March, Greta Thunberg told me she was not impressed with the Biden administration's progress on climate change. She still isn't. This is appeal to inappropriate authority. Greta Thunberg is not an expert on science or climate change. She's an advocate, but she's not an expert. Basically, Democrats say the government should control everything. Well, this is a straw man or scarecrow fallacy because it mischaracterizes the beliefs of the Democrats. They don't believe that the government should control everything. Their beliefs are more nuanced than that. Finally, we have abortion is the murder of unborn children, therefore it is morally wrong. This is begging the question, because the premise is just as controversial as the conclusion. In fact, the premise is identical to the conclusion. Murder is defined as a morally wrong killing, so...
Hey, fallacies!